3, 2, 1.
In Disneyland Paris, baseball stadiums in America, Dracula's castle in Romania, and just your regular doctor's office down under. People are rolling up their sleeves all over the place to get the coronavirus jab. So far, 700 million vaccinations have been given out around the world, and it seems to be making a difference. In the US, where at least 1 in 3 people have now been vaccinated, the rate of new COVID cases has dropped heaps since the beginning of the year. It's a similar story in the UK, where more than half of the population has been vaccinated, and life's starting to return to normal.
So 2 years ago today, I went to a concert, and now I'm back again. It just feels amazing.
It feels amazing.
But of course, in some countries, it's not such a good news story.
Our healthcare workers are completely prepared for the vaccination drive, but we do not have vaccines.
In many developing countries like India, the death rates are rising. And experts say a big part of the problem is not getting access to enough of these. So far, almost half of COVID vaccines have been given to people in wealthier parts of the world, like Europe, the UK, and North America. Whereas in developing countries, only 1 in more than 500 people have been vaccinated. That's not just a problem for people who live there, it's a problem for all of us. Experts say our best chance of getting rid of COVID is through something called herd immunity. You see, for a virus to survive, it needs a place to live. And if a big part of the community, the herd if you will, is protected, then it has nowhere to go and disappears. Bye-bye, virus. But to get herd immunity, you need to vaccinate as many people as possible as quickly as possible. Otherwise, the virus has time to spread and mutate into new strains. It's why for months now, experts have been calling on wealthy countries to do more to help developing countries get vaccinated. Vaccines aren't cheap. In fact, it can cost up to $50 for the 2 shots needed per person. And if you're vaccinating millions of people, that can add up to hundreds of millions of dollars. It also costs money to transport, store, and give out the vaccines. And with only a certain amount being made, there have been plenty of disagreements about who should get them first. Some reckon that could be fixed by letting more companies and more countries make the vaccines. You see, like most inventions, vaccines are protected by intellectual property rights, which means the company that puts heaps of money and time into creating and testing them are the ones that get to make and sell them. But that's something some people want to change. The World Health Organization, the US, and a bunch of other countries are now pushing to temporarily change the intellectual property rights. That would mean sharing how the vaccines are made and could ramp up production and give developing countries access to cheaper versions.
We've seen the tragedy in India. We need to avoid that same tragedy occurring in other countries, and some other countries are heading in that direction.
But some people don't think it's a good idea. They say making COVID vaccines is really tricky and that others may not do it properly or safely. For the laws to change, all the countries in the World Trade Organization will have to agree, which won't be easy. In the meantime, some wealthier countries have been helping developing ones by sending vaccines their way. And if there's one thing pretty much every country agrees on, it's that however it happens, we'll all be better off if we're COVID-free.